Max. Oklahoma Attorney General Scott Pruitt says his office is reviewing yesterday's U.S. Supreme Court decision, striking down a Texas abortion law that's similar to one here in Oklahoma. Now, the high court found the Texas law had unnecessary medical regulations and ruled the state restricted a woman's right to an abortion. Now, joining me live right now on the phone is Oklahoma Senator James Lankford. Good morning, Senator.
Good morning to you.
Now, tell me, what exactly is your reaction to yesterday's decision?
Well, very disappointed, obviously. Every way that we can, we try to stand up for not only the life of the child, but also the life of the mother. In the 1970s, the Supreme Court created this right to abortion. In the 1990s, they came back and said, but states have the ability to be able to regulate, both for the health of the mother and for the health of the child. And they keep coming back to the term viability. Now they've muddied that spring. And it'll be very, very difficult for states to be able to determine how do we protect the life of a mother as well as try to be able to stand up for the life of children.
So, Senator, what do you think this means for Oklahoma, and how do we move forward now?
Well, the Attorney General obviously will have to go through the Oklahoma statute. There will be yet another court challenge on that issue, and the courts will again fight this through. But at the end of the day, states do have a responsibility to be able to stand up. This ruling or this law was very, very specific. It dealt with the ability for any abortion clinic to have a basic surgical center standards, what would be in any other location where they do any kind of surgery. The Supreme Court yesterday basically said, well, if you do surgery, then you're going to have certain standards unless you're doing surgery that involves abortion. And then apparently with their mind, it doesn't have to have standards. I would not think that's a good idea for the health of mothers long term. And for that particular patient, obviously, abortion clinic already destroys the life of one. We want to make sure it also is protecting the life of the other. And so this will be an ongoing conversation because it is very important that states have the ability to be able to stand up for their own citizens.
And Texas and Oklahoma aren't alone. We have Missouri and Kansas with similar bills. Do you expect Attorney General Scott Pruitt to make any changes to our state laws? Or attempt to.
I will allow Attorney General Pruitt, who's incredibly competent in these areas, to be able to make his own determination there. I would tell you that Oklahoma should continue to do whatever we can, though, to be able to stand up and protect the life of the mother. This particular ruling makes it more difficult to read rather than easier. In the past, it was a pretty clear ruling, and it was a pretty clear standard that it had a high bar for a state, had the primary position to be able to make decisions what it takes to be able to protect its citizens. Now that's really muddy, and it's going to be hard to be able to tell any statute, whether it's a fire code or whether it's basic protections. As we've seen in cities like Philadelphia, where there was a horrible abortion clinic there that did not hold the basic standards, we wouldn't want to see that anywhere in the country for any kind of surgical procedure. But now the Supreme Court wants to create what Justice Thomas called a special right. That is beyond any other right, that you could ignore other basic things if abortion's involved. And I would just say no. We still have the right to be able to protect our citizens.
Senator James Lankford, thank you very much for joining us this morning.
Time right now is 6:00.